design should be very simple. It should not be very complex. You know, it is
exactly okay.
Yeah,
it should be intuitive.
Correct.
Not assuming. It should be intuitive. A lot of difference between assuming what my customers want and developing an intuition on at what stage what would they need.
Okay. What's up, people? My name is Ankit Dwal. Welcome to Mountwood Studio Show. Do you know how to run a design business successfully? No? I can teach you. Stay tuned, because what's coming next can change your entire life.
Correct. And I was going through a Netflix documentary where they were saying that, I don't remember the person's name, he invented the Facebook like button. So for women, it would be like, okay, what is there in the button? The data that you are getting from there, how many people are liking their post. And now let's take this scenario to a bigger picture. Let's suppose you are in Bangalore. Okay, sitting at your home, liking and sharing your post with others and saying something very funny. The number that, like, 400 people have liked your post. Okay, or let's suppose even the 20 people have liked your post. There are smileys put over there. There might be some people who will be giving you a heart smiley, a very sad smiley, something like that. So these are the data and the emotions that a consumer is having. So these are the thing I feel like UX is connected with this, because how you are dealing.
Yes.
Yeah, and
I'll give you a very similar example, Ankit. Like moving your example forward. Let's say we designed a button in your application, right, which helps me to react to the kind of post that you have posted, right? So maybe I am liking it, maybe I am loving it. Okay, maybe I am expressing my curiosity to your post through the same button, right?
Mm-hmm.
We're talking about the same. So now let's say you are a company, you are Mountwood Studios, right? Now you're looking at your posts and you're seeing how many people love it, how many people are curious, how many share it, right? You're looking at that. Then you come across, out of your 10 posts that you have done, you come across 3 posts where you see these have been shared a lot and received the love a lot from the people compared to the other posts.
Mm-hmm.
So now you look at these 3, you will start to see a trend forming. A trend might be like people want to listen to more podcasts, or maybe they want, you know, quick snapshots of your podcast or a recap session or anything, right? Or just photographs of cute animals and dogs or anything, right? And if that works for you, will you not start posting more and more similar posts in your feed?
Yeah, definitely. Take this example more further. Like, right.
And will this not in turn help you with your revenue and your customer base?
Definitely, definitely. And same thing is happening with the Instagram. Like the actual data you will be getting when you are reaching like 100 followers. And then you can see the 7 days data, or the 28 days data. When was your post performing the most? At which time? So when this data is collected and analyzed, which was the post which performed which much better and where you were lacking? So when this data is collected and then put together, analyzed, a decision is made that, yes, I have to go in this particular direction. So, I think these are the very great examples. Normal people usually don't.
In fact, what happens is when you design a user experience of a app or a digital product like Instagram, maybe you are thinking, okay, maybe he has different memories of the same place. So maybe he's using, you know, putting in a slideshow kind of carousel kind of environment where you can put in like 2 to 3 different posts of different angles of the same, let's say, monument, right? Now, any interface, you have given the liberty to the user. So what happens is, maybe he's using it in a different way. You can never, you know, like force somebody to use your interactions the same way, right? So correct. What people are doing now, people are using the carousel to present information. They're putting in some information on the first page, slide it. There's the second page, even more information, third page, the exact information you're looking for, right? So now this, what it does, it improves the engagement rate, because people are now interacting with your feed. So now people are using this. Instagram saw the trend and how everybody is using carousels to post and boost their online presence. Instagram started putting analytics on the carousel and started, you know, change their algorithms to see how much interactiveness and engagement rate your posts have through these carousels. So everything, and they are giving you visibility again. They're providing more visibility, and in turn, it's all turning up into your revenue and their revenue. And
yeah, it's like so more of a win-win situation. Yeah, win-win situation for the, yeah. Let's suppose for the Mountfoods also, if I'm saying when my posts are performing better, what kind of users are interacting with it, whether they are belonging to the design industry or from the other industry. Okay.
Definitely.
And similarly, there might be some other kind of people. Let's suppose banks, finance companies. Yeah. There might be some CEOs who are having their own page, and they want to see if I'll be posting this, what kind of message and what kind of interactions I will be having with the other users. And all this data is collected by the Instagram, and they are taking it. Putting out to the world, and then comes the business part, the main revenue
definitely.
Part from where the Instagram is.
So running. What I was saying, Ankit, where I was leading this conversation to is, now you asked me what UX is, right? User experience. Yeah,
correct.
From my perspective, where I am designing a user experience, I start with a hypothesis. Okay, maybe they want more interaction. And then I have the data to see, okay, yeah, people are using this in the different fashion, maybe different from what I imagined, but they are using it. And then I start testing it. Then I start putting in the analytics and see, is it growing? Yes, it is growing exponentially. Good for me. Why should I assume what my customers are doing? I can just start with a hypothesis and look into the data. So UX is not about assumptions. UX is where your entire Instagram experience is moving towards. Right?
Yeah. So this is like your definition, and it can vary according to the different.
Definitely, UX. Definitely.
Yeah, definitely. Mm-hmm. And I think by having or giving an example, there's more clarity to a question, and definitely there will be answer and the definition that you just gave me. That's very nice. Yeah. And let's talk about how you landed to Byju's. And we all know how is Byju's right now. You're a business development executive, right?
Over there. Yeah.
So yeah. Like BDM profile is different from the design or the UX research.
Actually, I had some family issues and health issues along the way. So when I left Lollipop, my parents, they are very old now.
Okay.
Both of them are retired, and so I just had to come back. There was no point in me being very far from home. I had to come back. So now what I liked about Byju's is, Byju's in my hometown, they are giving me, you know, the ability to perform well, and they are giving me an opportunity, and good payment, right? Like here, if I talk about the scenario, people say India is the next billion users, right? They say NBU, and look at India, look at Asia, because the next billion users are coming from Asia. So it's a very huge potential. why did Mark Zuckerberg and his wife Chan, they invest in Baidu's? Because Baidu is catering to the next billion users, right? And what happens is, when I came to my hometown here in Uttar Pradesh, Lucknow and Kanpur region, I saw that they are willing to give me, let's say, the kind of money that I was expecting there in Bangalore.
Okay.
So why should I leave my home, my parents and all my other moral responsibilities and duties and go to a faraway land, you know, and settle there and start doing things?
Yeah, I can understand.
The same opportunities here, why not? It suits my needs, right?
Correct.
Who wants to leave their home and go out and, you know, start from the beginning again?
So, like, what is your role?
But it was a brief job, so I just did it. It was more about academic counseling and personalizing the learning methods for children.
Okay.
So it was okay with me, and I was doing that. And I used to counsel students on, I would take the test and see how they were doing in a setting and how they, you know, it's very, very much like usability testing. So you would go into their homes and I would ask them, okay, beta, so tell me, how do you solve this problem? How do you do this? Tell me a table or something like that. Tell me a poem, something like that. And I would analyze them about their learning pedagogy.
The scenario has been changed from the corporate sector. You were having that experience and now being implemented to those small students. Yeah.
Yeah, definitely. And then I would see how they learn. What everybody learns in a very different way, right? So I would see how they would learn and how they would grow and what is the techniques they use. So I would, then I would, you know, suggest them a personalized program. And tell them, okay, if you use this tool that Baidu is providing and this is your current method of learning, and if you use this in this scenario, maybe you will have a growth. So I would give them it for, let's say, 1 month. I would say, check your performance. If it is going well for you, please go ahead and, you know, enroll in the entire course. Students would love it. They loved it and they enrolled it, and a lot of the students started calling me, okay, sir, you suggested this to my classmate, even I want the same, because even I am having trouble with my current learning skills and everything. I'm like, yeah, good. So that is how it works. But there are a brief stint, because I am at heart, I am always into product design and other things. So academic counseling was a brief stint, but it was okay. It was good.
Like, there's one more example. I was watching one documentary on Discovery Channel. It was long back ago. And they were having some problem. They have developed a solution for that. But to test that solution, they were not going to younger generation. They were targeting like 5 to 10 years. And then 10 to 15, 11 to 15. And then they will not go more than that. They wanted to see how easy a system is. So they contacted the parents, and then small children were there, because if they like the color, okay, no, this is not the scenario, I don't like it. Okay, so when the data was collected, and then they were taking the decisions, I was like, at that time I was not knowing what they are doing. I was like, I was just enjoying the show, but looking at the picture right now, I now understand what they were doing and how they were taking the decisions to make the software or whatever the system they were having to make it more easier. And I think design is all about making things simpler so that it can be used by millions of or billions of people.
Definitely.
Yeah. So
in fact, at one time during my stay, my work in Lollipop, have you heard about this person called Alok Nandi?
No.
Okay. So at that point of time, he was the president of Human Factors, I guess, Human Factors International, or HCI, either of the two. Sorry, man, you shouldn't be just stating. So Alok Nandi came to Lollipop and he said, something that, you know, just changed my perception about design. He said, you see, I asked him, what are you currently involved in? Because we had some time and we were sitting right there and I was following him and he was also following me back on LinkedIn. And so even before that scenario, I knew him. Okay. I had some small talks with him beforehand. So then I asked him, what are you doing right now? Like, what kind of project? He said, the government of France and other people, they have started a design department along with their engineering department. I said, what? He said, yes, they have started a design department along with the engineering department. And now the solution, the streets, the pavements, the shops, everything that is being designed for the citizens of France, everything has a design. It is going through a design department. All the functions are more accessible by people. You know, and better solutions.
Mm-hmm.
It led me to believe, yeah, even the people of India can use the same context and same approach to designing our own roads, our own buildings and public spaces, right? And so then I realized, okay, design is everywhere, not in the digital product or the hardware product. Design can be everywhere, right? And maybe it is me who was introduced very later stage to design. Maybe other people are not, but yeah, design is taking a very back step in our society. And I think it is the time now for designers to come forward.
Mm-hmm. I totally agree.
People start addressing designers, the word that, because design is the core. You need it at the beginning, right? Mm-hmm. Not only at the end to test your product. You need it at the beginning as well to plan your entire, you know, journey of designing and developing.
Yeah, like one of my friend who is developing an app, he is playing with the colors. So let me give you an example. This is the real example, and he has tested this. He is a developer, UX researcher, designer, because he likes to be alone and create something like this. So he has designed his app, and with colors, what kind of mood you were having yesterday, and if you were to have your mood was very good today, so what you will open the app and say, like, choose the color, rate it from red to green or in between, whatever the colors are, and at the month end of the month, you can analyze that, why I was sad, why I was happy. So now it is being taken to the neurological department also to analyze the human behavior, and then it will be taken further. So yeah, like you are saying this, design can be anywhere, in the buildings and in our roads, and Indians need to understand and analyze everything on this part. Yeah, and the voice that we both are taking to the design community will be definitely help others to understand what actually design is all about, and it is very important. We both are having a very good experience in the corporate world. So let's suppose I have to become a UX researcher. So how should I start my journey? Because we both have different backgrounds. So we shifted.
Definitely, definitely.
But
so to address your question, let me ask you, are you looking at a solution that is for people who have already completed their college, or they are just completed their class 12 and now they are looking at the various options and want to move into UX field or research field?
We can do the both.
Or maybe both.
Because a plus 2 student or the 12 student doesn't know. It's like,
Definitely.
My friend has gone.
They're very misguided, easily misguided. Maybe I was definitely misguided. You told me, just, you know, there's no scope in doing this or that. Just go with a traditional business like engineering or traditional field like engineering, because that is the way to be. And I was not looking at anything else. I was like, okay, yeah, sure. Why not? Everybody is an engineer in the family. Let me also be an engineer in the family.
No, but I have wanted to become an engineer. So I haven't opted.
Definitely. No, that is correct. That is even very good. But a lot of people, just for the lack of options, they just don't know what to pursue. Right. And so if I'm talking about 10 plus 2 students, I would say cognitive science. Right. Cognitive science is look for multidisciplinary approaches, because even the new education policy that has come in place here in India, it's talking about multidisciplinary education, right? So at 10 plus 2, look at multidisciplinary courses like cognitive science, or you go for design institutions like NID. Of course, they have only 10-15 seats per, so it's very difficult. But don't be like harassed, and be up to, if you can go to colleges like Srishti or other places, and look for design backgrounds. Because if you are putting in an effort of 3 to 4 years in your undergraduate, and if you learn what we have learned the hard way, if you want to learn it in a school or curriculum, go for such curriculums. Because neuroscience, design, information design, digital design, new media design, product design, everything, all these, they are designers, but never people from one trade. Designers, let's talk about old designers, like, you know, who was the oldest designer that can come to our mind? Maybe
Paul Rand. Who did Paul Rand?
Even no, let's talk way back, like,
okay,
let's say medieval times. Let's talk about Renaissance, or those designers. They used to work at metal, you know, goldsmiths, blacksmiths, right? They used to work with carpenters, they used to work with at forge machines, they used to work at different places. They were designing, some were designing gardens, some were designing something else, some were painting every day. So art and design was very interchangeably used until 2-3 decades back, right? And like for students, 10 plus 2 students or new students who are just getting into this field or want to get in, I would suggest go for multidisciplinary approaches. Because if you have multidisciplined mindset, or your skill set will be to derive from other forms and other functions, and that is how you would get into and design a good solution. Right? If you think it from a very one narrow perspective, one single perspective, you'll never be able to design for everybody or very usable solution. If you can inculcate 2-3 different mindsets or skill sets, that is the best thing to do, right? And for people who are people like me, who after doing a graduation and then they realized, okay, maybe design is my calling, and you want to be a UX researcher, UX designer, then you look at your analytical skills and your observation skills, and you start working on that. You start learning what different technologies and tools are, different methodologies are. It's no problem. I did not know how to use Adobe XD until recently, okay? So because it was never used. So Adobe XD and everything else, they are not required. They're just tools which you can learn at any point of time and start doing a lot of things. But so UX is beyond tools. Try to remember that.
Okay.
Design is putting in form and function together. That is design. Mm-hmm. And UX, which is a subset of design, that is user experience design, involves interaction design and other things, other approaches, and user-centered approaches, there the most important skill set to have is analysis and observation. If you can observe people and analyze and create useful trends and, you know, pinpoint the trends or the shift changes that are happening in the industry or along the user base that you are researching for, then it's great, because now you have workable insights, the insights that can actually lead to a good solution. So like, go for, even if you are not getting a UX researcher role, go for analytical roles, or go for observational roles, go for creating roles, like even product management, associate product management, or UX analyst, or I'm just talking from my experience. There might be a lot of different ways achieve the same.
That's totally fine, because
yeah.
We are here to listen to you and about your experiences.
Yeah, but these are the soft skills. Definitely, these are the soft skills that are required.
Okay.
Because you are looking at day-to-day work is churning the data, interviewing the users, collaborating with other teams and stakeholders to develop the insights, presenting those insights, you know, so that people can actually see value in what we are doing and actually see value in changing their current mindset to a different mindset, right? So look for those roles. And unlike developed nations like the States or other forward, technologically forward places, right, India and the scenario of Indians working here is very different, right? And I don't want to go into the negative aspect of it, but there's still a lot of, you know, place for improvement, room for improvement, and people right now don't understand maybe the importance. So they might tell you, okay, you don't know a certain tool like MS Visio or OmniGraphle or user Zoom or things like that, or InVision, you Adobe XD for that matter. Maybe you don't know, so maybe you won't be able to fit in. It's all right. Because realize that you have the potential to observe and analyze and move in that direction.
Okay.
That will again reiterate and say that again.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah. Like, for some people, I'll get back to the example of developing a logo design. Let's take an example of a website. For some, they just search in and best template for this, and that's it. But in reality, what they should be doing is starting from the sketching part, okay, then wireframing, and then developing the prototype, and then coming to the website. And then
So you have your process. You make yourself well aware about that process, right?
Mm-hmm.
Like the process you just said, the wireframing, prototyping, researching, wireframing, prototyping, testing, right? Mm-hmm. And iterating. So for point one is understand this process, how it works at different stages. For logo design, how it works. For app design, how it works. For dashboard design, how it works.
For any product design. Yeah.
Product design, service design. Right? And second thing is mixed methods.
Mm-hmm.
You can't have one method that will help you in all the phases of designs. You will have to have mixed methods and applied product research. When I say mixed method, it's about maybe you need to do a red route analysis. Maybe you need to do prioritize your task. So maybe you need to do a red route. Maybe you need to do usability testing. Maybe you need to do, you know, cart sorting. Maybe sometimes an open cart sorting technique, maybe a closed cart sorting technique. There are n number of tools and technologies, just like I said. But you all you have to do is start figuring out how, which methods to be used when for the most optimal solutions, because people are not patient with R&D people like us, right?
So I want to
know the mixed method.
Yeah. Why it is getting delayed? I can understand, because talking about the R&D, we'll get back to you. One of my client came in and they wanted to launch a toffee. Okay, I said, okay. First of all, the very basic reason is why you want to go with this. He gave me all the examples that we are having an orchard, mango orchard, and then guava orchard, and we will be taking out the juice, and then whatever the process of a toffee, but we need packaging for that, and it should look good. Okay, I said, okay, we'll do this. But before, you know, getting the final product of the packaging, there will be the research part and everything else. So they said it's a 50 paisa toffee only. So why are you investing so much of your time, and why are you doing all the R&D? I said, look, this is a process, and a research needs to be done so that how a wrapper should be opened. Like if you take the example of a few toffees who will be like opened like this. Okay, there are some toffee like Mentos. It's a bubble kind of thing. You can just put it in your mouth and there will be a pop-up sound. Okay, so I gave them the other examples. Right now, these are the examples that are coming into my mind. And there are certain wrappers which needs to be opened like this. Tear it off and then you can eat it.
Like Cadbury's.
And they eventually show this thing in their ads also. Like, this is how you have to open.
That is entire like a field of package designing, right?
Yeah, and it's very important to get the self-presence, because if your packaging is not shiny or it's very dull, it is not giving the proper message to the consumer, how it will make the shelf presence. And if the packaging is going wrong, let's suppose there's a box, it needs to be open like this, or there will be like a Tropicana package. Tropicana is not an exact example for this.
I understand, for the sake of honesty.
The toffee needs to be, you know, collected, and the jar should be very neat and clean. All the description should be there. And to all gather all this information and look for the competitors, what they are doing. We have to do certain R&D. So they told me like how much time it will take. I said, these are the months that we will be investing. And they said, no, this is not happening. We can't invest so much in time. Okay, it's up to you. And the deal was not finalized. So when you gave an example of R&D, this example came to mind.
Yeah, definitely. Even if you are this was a client that came to you, right?
Mm-hmm.
So it's, let's say you're operating like a studio or a independent design consultant. But even if you are based in a product-based company and they have an entire center for R&D where people are dedicated in R&D, there also you don't have like a lot of patience with these people, because like, but you are a cost center to us. You're not sales, which is bringing in money. But if that is what I said, I worked in a product-based company, and every week, at least twice, I would have to have 1 hour sessions just to tell them what we're doing is actually helping them create more money and helping them not lose the money in the process. So not losing money also is a win-win situation, right?
Yeah. For R&D, Tesla is a very good example. They invest a lot of money.
But Tesla is okay. Tesla is like one of the big majors, and maybe everybody can't be at this level. But yeah, definitely. So have mixed methods. That is what I was saying.
Yeah.
When you have mixed methods, you know which of the two or three methods you need, or how many actually users you will need. Let's say you can have 100 users. But at some point of time, you can have 6 users and be able to, you know, align all your thoughts. So minimum users and minimum methods, use the set of these mixture and develop your solution. Mm-hmm. Like, don't assume, but use mixed methods.
Mm-hmm.
That is what I would suggest.
Okay.
Right.
Yeah.
Keep researching, keep studying, you know, keep educating yourself on new things, like go through the basics of Don Norman, or go through the basics of Nielsen Norman Group, or McKinsey's Digital Pumpkin and their publication, or things like that. But just read books. Like, there are a lot of good books that are coming in. So stay away from the jargons. Please stay away from the jargons. Right?
Yeah.
There are 10,000 jargons for one simple verse, and like, don't get caught up in the jargon, because mm-hmm. literature has no end, right? And don't get caught up in the jargon, but learn the difference between different methods and different approaches.
Okay.
And use it.
Mm-hmm.
So it's very required. They keep learning, and because one size does not fit all. So every challenge, even in the same product, every challenge will require a different approach, a different mindset.
Mm-hmm.
If everything is the same mindset, again, you are getting away from your multidisciplinary approach. So you need mixed methods, and you need to be iterative. Don't be married to your designs. Please
don't fall in love.
Yeah,
fall
in love what you created just because you created it. Right?
Yeah, in aptitude, when you are pursuing your coaching to crack the exams, they said don't fall in love with the questions. Similarly, don't fall.
Exactly. Like,
yeah.
One thing that I learned and through like the CEO of Doveri is a very good friend of mine, right? Because we were both dedicated to the same goal, and we would like work 24/7. Not that I am saying I am a workaholic or the culture was bad. It's like our minds would be at the same, you know, same focused at the same energy, with the same energy towards the same goal. So he made me realize that shipping always beats perfection.
Mm.
Right? So if you can ship the product at the deadline or before the deadline, it's better than crossing the deadline and trying to perfect it. Nothing's perfect ever. If you can ship it, you will always have value. Wait for the next iteration or the next sprint and just make a note of all the things you want it to still have, and do it in the next sprint. But at this deadline, just ship it at whatever stage you are in, right? So that is always better, to ship it rather than perfecting it.
We have spent my experiences, I'm not total experience is like 5+ years right now,
yeah.
And
yeah.
Your experience is almost similar. Okay, and what are the design problems that you see in an industry, and not specifically in the design industry?